late season, you've not filled your buck tag, is it possible to fill a tag late season? The answer is yes. I have a lot of success hunting late season. I'm gonna tell you guys a few of the tips that's helped make me successful, especially as the winter months get colder and the deer get more hungry. Late season, a lot of people wanna hang up their bows and their rifles and they wanna quit, they wanna tap out. They're cold, they've had an unsuccessful hunt early in the season, and they don't think it's gonna be good, whereas late season can be very, very beneficial to the hunter if you can get out there. So there's a few things I like to focus on to put the odds in my favor. First off, I wanna go after the food source that's in the area, whether it be food plots, or you can supplemental feed, or you've only got native habitat. You've gotta put your boots on the ground, you've gotta get out there and see what food that you have that's available to the deer in that time. Brassicas or even certain grasses can be great late winter sources of food that really will pull in the deer. And if you only have native browse to hunt over, that's not a bad thing. Deer feel really comfortable in that kind of element. They can bed in there, they can feed in there, and they spend just a majority of their time in there. So if you can find that native browse late season, any kind of green food source in there, they're gonna like woody stems. They're gonna get in there, they're gonna browse on sassafras. Any kind of twig that's kind of new growth from this last year is probably going to be hit on first off, but this is where it really comes into play to putting boots on the ground and getting back into your property and seeing what they're hitting on. You can't do that from the couch, you can't just guess. You've got to get out there, look at what you're seeing active browse on, and if you have to, move your stand, move your blind, and set up in that area. The deer are going to go where the food is regardless of anything. The second main thing I like to look for late season, it's cold. The deer want to thermal regulate and they want cover. They want that thick cover where they can get in there and they are going to be able to regulate their body temperature. So they're spending a lot of time there. They're bedding in there. A lot of times they're browsing in there. And the deer during late season get on that same pattern that they were early season. It's bedding to feed, almost on even a more rigorous schedule because their bodies are trying to keep up, their metabolism's going, they're trying to stay warm, and so they're a lot more active. But it's a good bet any time of day that the deer would be up moving, they're gonna be in your food plots, they're gonna be in your native browse, they're gonna be somewhere where there's still food. So once you found your food source, once you find where they're bedding, where they're feeding, and you get them on that pattern, you're probably gonna have to move your tree stand or your blind setup. I've preached that a lot through this series that you have to be adaptable because the deer are always changing patterns, and that's the same case here. You are probably hunting somewhere different in early season where the deer were patterned on, and they're gonna be a completely different pattern now. So it's time to get out there. If you have to take down your blind, set up your blind in a new area, your tree stand in a new area to give you that shot opportunity to get on those deer that are now patterned differently than they were early season. Now, if you have the option to do supplemental feeding, this can be very beneficial to the deer during this time. I would encourage you to keep up with it. If you're going to feed them, then keep up with it through the remaining part of the winter because they're starting to rely on that food source, but it can be beneficial. There's no guarantee when you're hunting over bait or attractant, whatever you want to call it, that you're going to kill. It's just not a guarantee. Some won't come in till after dark. Sometimes those older bucks, they just like to circle downwind and not come in till after dark, but it can aid you in hopefully filling your tag. So late season hunting can be pretty easy, pretty straight and forward. It just takes somebody that wants to put up with the wind, with the cold, with all the elements that play into that time of year to get out there and hopefully fill a tag.